Hey, you guys, I'm back with a book review, and as you see, this book is titled Euphoria, and it is by J. Asmara. Before I can even say anything about the book review, can you guys please get into this book cover with me? When I saw this, I said, oh, okay, like the chocolate on skin, like the flames had me all in. I don't know what it is about orange next to black skin, but it just had me like, you know what? I'm excited to read this book. So, if you guys want to see everything I have to say about this book, because y'all know it's clearly an erotica, stay tuned. All right, so this book is by J. Asmara and Michelle Kay. So, it's a collection of short stories, right? And I was blown away. Because the short stories all, like, it's not like they necessarily have a theme. They're all eroticas. But what I did like was even the first short story in the book. It's called Poetic Seduction. And I don't know what it is, but I love those stories in those books about, like, basically like an age gap. Like, not in like a creepy way of like the person's like 16, they're dealing with a 32-year-old. Not like that, but like as in like, so the guy is like in his early 20s and the woman he's interested is in like in her 40s or so. So it's like I like those type of books or whatever. So this short story really spoke to me because for starters, they're talking about poetry and they're going to poetry events and he's seeing her there, and since she is some years older than him, he's kind of sort of nervous to approach her because he doesn't want to get shut down. And I kind of was like, boy, if you don't just go up there and say something to her, like he'd be buying her drinks from across the bar and stuff. I'm like, if you don't just stop playing, go on ahead. The worst thing she could do is say no. Like, I don't know. I thought the story was cute because I don't know. I always just think of like those books, not the book, the movie. I'm pretty sure there is a book about it first that came out. But basically, Stella Got Her Groove Back. Like, that's like what always comes to mind when I see books with like this theme. And I just be like, you know what, girl? You might as well go on ahead. Y'all both grown, so might as well do whatever y'all gonna do. And that is what happened. Like, they did end up hitting it off. But then the next story in the book, too. I'm trying to find the title for you guys so I'm not just going off on the deep end. I feel like I done scrolled past it. No, I didn't. I'm still scrolling. Let me see. I definitely have scrolled past it. My eyes are messing up, and one of them is weeping right now, so I'm not really able to find it. But I do remember the gist of the story. This one was with a woman, and basically she was married, and she was saying too, like, how her husband, like, she was in love with him, like, when they first got married. And it's not like necessarily they're having marital problems. She just more so, it didn't even necessarily seem like she was bored. It just kind of seemed like she was just like up for whatever. Like, it's not like her and her husband are swingers, but it kind of seemed like, too, if her husband had said one day, like, you know what, I think we should become swingers, it didn't really seem like she'd be the type to be all that combative from it. But what happens is there's a winter storm, and one of her colleagues at work is on his way up to her house to drop something off to her. So what happens is her husband is away. He's supposed to be on his way home, but they kind of get snowed in. So she has this extreme attraction to men that's older than her. I believe she's in her 20s, but she was saying too that she prefers men that are like over 45, in their 50s. And her husband is in his 40s. So she's like happy with him, but this man, her coworker, is in his 50s, right? And he got the gray hairs, and that's what she like, and this and that. So it was like a kind of like a, oh God, I don't even want to say page turner, but it was one of them books that it was one of those stories, because this is one of the stories inside of the book. It was one of those stories where it kind of had you like, girl, what's about to happen? Like, are they about to mess with each other? Is she like, is her husband gonna walk in the door? Like, are they gonna get caught? Like, how long is this gonna go on for? Because it seemed like her and like the coworker, they had a lot of similarities. It just was like, how is this gonna work? So There are a few. I'm trying to see how many short stories are in this book. I'm trying to scroll really quick for you guys so I could see. There's definitely more than three or four. Again, I'm kind of like on my Fetty Wap right now of like squinting with one eye just to try and see through the pages of the book because I don't know what's going on in my eye right now, but it's like weeping really bad. So I really don't, I honestly can't count specifically the number of short stories in there, but I do highly recommend this book. This is not the first book that I've read with J.S. Mara. I know for a fact this is not the first book that I've read. Now, if you asked me to name the other books off the top of my head right now, I know for a fact that I wouldn't be able to do that because my memory just. I know for a fact that was over 4 or 5 months ago that I reviewed those books, but I will definitely put them at the end of this video so you guys can see because I have reviewed some of her books and I know that I like them. This was the first book that I had read with the person that she wrote the book with, and that was Michelle Kay. So, them coming together was a fire combination. I haven't read a book by Michelle Kay alone, but I would definitely be open to after this because, good God. I feel like it just was one of those books where it was like, you know what? Maybe I need to try that next time. So, you guys, y'all know how I am. This book was definitely a 5-star read to me. I can't say too much more without giving away the book for the simple fact of, let me see, this book wasn't that long. Like, it. Okay, it's saying the book was 265 pages. Maybe I just spiff. I enjoyed the book. I felt like it wasn't that. I like short stories, so to me, it probably wasn't that bad. I was reading about two, three of them a night, so maybe that's why it wasn't that bad because I was actually my attention was on the book. So, you guys, if you have read a book by either of these authors before, drop something below and let me know what you thought about them, what book by them I should read next because I definitely would be up for it. So, for now, you guys, I am out.